She's chosen to nest on this wind-blasted cliff for a very good reason. To take off, she spreads her 3-meter wings, and the cliff-top wind provides the lift. Ungainly on land, she's now in her element. Out here, finding fish and squid is like looking for needles in a haystack. So a mother albatross will scour the ocean for up to 600 miles a day. During her lifetime, she'll travel 1.5 million miles. That's to the moon and back 3 times. And remarkably, she can do this with barely a wing beat. She's one of the world's most efficient flyers, using the energy of the air just above the ocean to save her own energy. She's riding the air like a roller coaster in a super efficient way. But snaking from side to side like this seems to make no sense at all, until you understand how air behaves above water. At the water's surface, the air collides with the rough waves, slowing it down to a virtual standstill. But 10 meters above the waves, the air flows that much faster. It's this difference in airspeed that allows the clever albatross to fly for free. By sweeping up and down, she can use both the fast air 10 meters above the waves and the still air at the water's surface. And here's where the sheer efficiency of those long, narrow wings is so important. As she climbs into the faster wind, she can create more and more free lift. Then, with height on her side, she turns sharply, and a combination of gravity and wind now slingshots her downwards at up to 75 miles an hour. Known as dynamic soaring, the ability to use changes in airspeed like this means that albatrosses rarely need to flap their wings.